Hello.
My name is Ioana and I'm an MFT trainee.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. I just want to let you know that this is a mock session which will be presented in front of my class. Mm-hmm. I just want to make sure that this is okay with you.
Mm-hmm.
And before we start our session, I would like to tell you that this conversation is confidential. What it said here stays here, except for if you are telling me that you're going to hurt yourself or hurt others, I have a duty to protect. Also, I am mandated by the state of California to report any child abuse, elder abuse, and dependent adult abuse. Are you okay with that?
Yeah.
Well, with all this being said, what brings you here today?
Well, my wife basically told me I have an anger problem, and she told me I need to come here to try and solve that problem.
So it was not your idea?
No. No, it definitely wasn't my idea to come here. I mean, I think I'm fine. You know, we get in a fight sometimes, and yeah, I raise my voice, I yell a little bit, but I think overall I'm fine. I don't think I have a problem.
Okay.
You know, she said that she was basically scared of me, so she took out a restraining order and against me. So now I'm like pretty much kicked out of the house.
So what do you think your wife hopes will happen in therapy?
Well, she's hoping I'll, in her eyes anyway, she's hoping I'll learn how to control my anger. Not yell so much, I guess.
What do you want?
Well, I want to be able to get back into my home. You know, I work really hard to, you know, support the household, and right now I'm kicked out of the house. So for me, that's very troubling.
So what will need to happen for you to be able to go back home?
Well, first, my wife needs to drop the restraining order. Because legally I can't get back in the house with that restraining order. So that needs to happen first. But I have a question for you. I noticed so far that you haven't actually asked me if I have physically hurt my wife or hit my wife.
I assume that if it's important for me to know, you will tell me.
Okay, yeah. So I really don't have to tell you my life story.
Not unless you think it will be helpful in solving the current problem. You said you want to get back into your house. What do you think your wife would say would have to be different for her to drop the restraining order?
Well, yeah, I mean, like I've said, I have to learn how to control my anger around her, basically. I guess one thought that's come through my head is when I start to get mad at her, I just take a walk. I just leave the situation.
So what would it take for you to be able to do that?
Well, She would have to stop lying to me. That's what really sets me off, when she's lying to me. So, I don't know. I mean, I think if that can happen, then that would help my situation a lot.
So when she stops lying, what would be different?
Well, if she wasn't lying to me, then I wouldn't be mad. That's what would be different.
Does she lie all the time?
No, I mean, the only time she lies is when she's going out with a friend or something, and I ask her, hey, where are you going tonight, or where are you headed? And I just notice like a hesitation in her response, and I can tell that she's trying to hide something from me. So that's, you know, that's when the anger starts to kick in for me.
So if you don't ask her where she's going, she doesn't lie to you.
Yeah, it's true.
So how do you know she's not lying?
Well, you know, when she's not lying to me, there's no hesitation in her response when I ask her a question or, what are you doing? There's no hesitation. She has a normal conversation with her, you know. It seems like when she's lying to me, her conversation's not spontaneous with me, I guess.
So, when she does that, what do you think she notices you do differently?
Well, yeah, she notices I don't get angry, I don't yell, don't raise my voice. Sometimes when I think she's lying, I'll pound my fist on the table, or maybe throw something, or, you know, if it's getting really bad. So yeah, she would notice that I don't do that if she's not lying.
So would that be a sign that you're controlling your anger?
Yeah, could be. Yeah, because if she's not lying, then that controls my anger.
So you are controlling your anger?
Because she's not lying to me.
Yeah.
Or at least I think, because of the way she's talking to me, I think that she's not lying to me.
So let me ask you a different type of question. Suppose that tonight, after this session, a miracle happens and the problems that brought you here disappear. What would be some of the first things you will notice that will be different, that will tell you that the miracle happened? The end.